Hello students, this is the organic lab and I am going to show you an experiment today, that is experiment number 1, that one is identification of solid known unknown, known or unknown organic sample. So in experiment number 1, generally we do lots of sample over here during the lab time. So out of that sample, out of that sample, today I am going to do a sample, that is glucose. So I already took some solid glucose over here, and to start this one, first of all we have to perform preliminary test, and then after that confirmatory test. So for preliminary test we have to follow a flow chart which I already pasted over here. So according to flow chart, the first test is solubility in water, okay, without heating. So to check the solubility, first of all we have to take a test tube, and then after that we have to take some solid sample from here. So I just take the solid sample, then after that we have to add some distilled water inside the test tube. See, now just shake like this way. It's nearly soluble. You can see nothing is present inside. So that means this is soluble. Okay, so this is the aqueous solution of glucose. I just keep this one over here in the test tube stand. So the next test is what is the next test? Next test is blue litmus test. Okay, so just I take a blue litmus paper from here, and for this also we have to make a aqueous solution of glucose, water solution of glucose, but I already prepared this one in my first test, so no need to prepare again. I just use this solution. Now I just scroll the paper like this way. So this is a blue litmus paper and this is our aqueous solution. I just put the paper like this way, this fashion. So you can see no changes in the paper, so that means you can say the solution is neutral solution. Okay, so our blue litmus test is over. So coming test is what? After blue litmus, ignition test is the coming test. So we have to do the ignition test. This is the flow chart, and this flow chart is clearly elaborated in another place that you can find in the experiment manual. Okay, so to doing the ignition test, what we have to do? We have to take a glass rod like this, and some of the sample we have to take the tip of the glass rod like this way, and that we have to put in the flame. So in the ignition test, two observations you can find. One is the sooty, another one is the non-sooty flame. So here you can find this gives you a non-sooty flame. Okay, if it is sooty, then it should be burned with golden yellow flame like candle after removing from the flame also. Okay, but see, this is not showing you a golden yellow flame. Okay, so that means what? This gives you a non-sooty flame. Okay, so our ignition test is over. Okay guys, so according to flow chart, coming test is what? Dry heat in a dry test tube, or you can say dry test tube heating. Okay, so once we got non-sooty flame,
Then coming test is dry test tube heating or heat in a dry TT means test tube. Okay, so for that we have to take a dry test tube. So I just take the dry test tube from there, and here we have to pour some solid organic sample. Then using a test tube holder, we have to hold the test tube like this way, and this one we have to put directly into the flame. Okay, so I just put it in the flame. The positive observation of this one is charring or not. So you can see it is already charred, and some browny blacky thing appear inside the test tube. Okay, so that means what? Dry test tube heating test for glucose is also positive. So that means this also completed. So after doing heat in a dry test tube, this we get positive. So according to flowchart, coming test is what? Test with the I2 solution. Okay, so if it give you positive, two results are coming, either it's positive or negative. Okay, so for doing the I2 solution test, what you have to do? First of all, we have to prepare a aqueous solution of our sample, that is for glucose. So just I take some glucose inside the test tube like the previous that I already did. Just add some distilled water inside the test tube. Let's shake this one, and this is almost soluble. Now our solution is prepared. So now we have to add over here I2 solution. That is a sample that you can find inside the lab that is already prepared, and this one is the iodine I2 solution. So I'm going to add some drops of this I2 inside the test tube. So you just see. So you can find no violet coloration over here. Okay, this is not violet. So no violet coloration means this is the negative observation of the glucose. Okay, so that means what? Our I2 solution test completed. Okay, so after doing the I2 solution test, we got negative observation over there. So according to flowchart, coming test is Fehling's test. Okay, so for Fehling's test, we have to prepare first of all Fehling's solution. So what is a Fehling's solution or Fehling's reagent? That is mixture of Fehling's A and Fehling's B. So first of all we are going to prepare Fehling's reagent. For that need a test tube. I take the test tube. So here you can find the reagents Fehling's A and Fehling's B. Okay, so I am going to add equal volume of Fehling's A and Fehling's B inside the test tube to prepare the Fehling's reagent. Okay, so first of all I am going to take some drops of Fehling's reagent. Suppose if I added 5 drops of A, that means I have to add again 5 drops of B. Now I add the two reagent over here in equal volume. So this is our Fehling's reagent or Fehling's solution. This is prepared. So I keep this one over here for the test. What? So for the test, what we have to do? We have to prepare a glucose solution again in water, and then we have to add that prepared filling solution into the glucose solution, and then after that we have to heat the test tube in the hot water bath. Okay, so just I take some solid glucose over here. Pouring some water, distilled water. Aqua solution prepared. Now I pour the prepared filling solution into this. Now using the test tube holder, I just put this one inside the hot water bath, and after putting inside the hot water bath, we have to wait some minutes. So just check this one whether it's coming or not. Some coloration is appear, you can see. Let this one heat little bit more. So you can see the color. You can say this test is positive for glucose. Actually you can find the color, bricky reddish color is appear over here, and this is the result of Fehling's test, and this one is positive for glucose. So Fehling's test is completed. Okay, so after the Fehling's, according to flowchart, coming test is Barfoot test. Okay, so for that again we have to prepare a aqueous solution of glucose that is already prepared over here. Okay, so this is the aqueous solution of glucose, and I am going to add Barfoot reagent into this. Okay, so here is the Barfoot reagent. This much volume is not needed actually. I just decrease some. Now Barfoot reagent I added over here. So after adding Barfoot reagent, this is the color after adding the Barfoot reagent, you can see. Okay, so in this case also, in this test also, we have to use the hot water bath. So using the test tube holder again, I put this one in the hot water bath. This also takes some time, so we have to wait some time. So I just check this one. Yeah, something is appear over here. Actually in this case also a red precipitation should come. So this one is not like the previous test, but at the bottom you can find some reddish thing is already deposited. Okay, and the color of the solution is also changed. It's not like the color when I add the Barfoot reagent initially. Okay, so that means this also positive. So according to flowchart, we complete all the preliminary test, and see after doing once we got the positive observation in the Barfoot test, you can say your sample may be glucose. Okay, so that means the preliminary test completed. Okay, so from preliminary test we get a idea that our sample may be glucose. Actually we are doing known, but sometime we provide you unknown samples. Okay, so now we have to perform some confirmatory test of the glucose. The test, all the test that we have to perform over here, that is provided in the manual, and that these are the tests. Okay, so here the first test is what? Again, failing test. Okay, so failings we already did in the preliminary, so no need to do it again for the confirmatory. Okay, so here is the result of the failings test. Okay, and that is positive. Then coming test is what? Second one is the tolerance test. Okay, so for tolerance test, what we have to do? First of all, we have to prepare a tolerance reagent. Okay, so for tolerance reagent, what we have to do? We have to take a test tube. First of all, we have to take 1 ml of silver nitrate solution. Okay, so this is the silver nitrate solution. I just take approximately 1 ml. This is approximately 1 ml. Okay. So now here I am going to add some drops of the sodium hydroxide. And after adding sodium hydroxide, see, this is the sodium hydroxide. This gives you a gray color precipitation. So see, the color is appear over here. Okay, so this is a precipitation actually. So we have to dissolve this precipitation using NH4H, ammonium hydroxide. Okay, so here is the ammonium hydroxide. I am going to add the ammonium hydroxide into this to dissolve this precipitation, and I am going to add this one drop by drop fashion. Okay, so by this way you can add So, I add some drop first of all. So, always you have to take care of this one. Okay, no extra NH4OH added into the test tube. That is why I am adding drop by drop. Again I added 3 drops. Now again I am taking this one, this also. Some of the parts is already dissolved. I think it's consumed some drops more. Oops, I added. Now see, a colorless solution is appear over here. Okay, so this is the tolerance reagent. Okay, so for the tolerance test, I already prepared tolerance reagent. Now I have to add this tolerance reagent into the aqueous solution of glucose. Okay, so aqueous solution is already prepared over here, so I am going to add this one into the glucose solution. This is the tolerance reagent. And and this we have to add heat in the hot water bath. Okay, now just check. Oh, fine. So see this one, guys, a nice silver mirror is appear in the inner wall of the test tube. So our tolerance test is also completed. Okay, so we already completed tolerance test. Now coming test is what? Coming test is the Mollis test. Okay, so for Mollis, what you have to do? First of all, we have to prepare a aqueous solution. So aqueous solution we have to prepare. So I'm going to prepare aqueous solution first of all. Aqueous solution is prepared almost. Yeah, solution is prepared. So from in the Mollis test, after preparing the aqueous solution, what you have to do? We have to add alcoholic solution of alpha naphthol. Okay, we have to add over here some drops of alcoholic 15% alcoholic solution of alpha naphthol. Okay, that is also a reagent you can find inside the laboratory. So I'm going to add this one over here. I added some drop over here. Now what do you have to do after this? We have to add some drop of concentrated H2SO4 into this mixture. Okay, so this is the concentrated H2SO4, and whenever you deal with the concentrated H2SO4, guys, you have to take extra care. Okay, so in inclined fashion I'm going to add this one over here. Actually, in Mollis test, this type of observations generally appear. So, actually, a ring is coming in the junction point of the two mixture. So, this also positive. So, our Mollis test is also completed. Okay, so after completing Mollis test, the coming test is Burford test. Okay, so that we already did in the preliminary. So this also no need to perform again. So we are going to perform the next test, that is lead acetate test. Okay, so for lead acetate test, what you have to do? Again, we have to prepare a aqueous solution of our sample. So aqueous solution
SACOS solution prepared. Here we have to add so you have to add lead acetate solution inside the aqueous solution of glucose. Okay. After adding lead acetate solution, we have to heat this mixture for few minutes. Actually, boiling is required, strong heat, so better to use flame, so I am going to use flame. Boil hoi gaya jata. So in this boiled solution we have to add some drop of NH4OH solution. So this is the NH4OH. I'm going to add some drops, and while I am adding, this will gives you a white coloration. I have to add some drop more for a permanent white color. Let it shake first of all. Then I am going to add again some drops of NH4OH. So now you can find a white precipitation over here. So this thing, after getting white precipitation, once it appears, we have to heat this mixture again. Okay. So just put this one over here in the hot water bath and just wait for a while. Let it be heated properly. So now just check. Yeah. So that pure white precipitation now converted into Solomon pink color. Okay. So this is the actual observation of the lead acetate test for glucose. So our lead acetate test is also completed. Okay. Okay. So you can see the 5 conformity tests over here. Okay. So after doing all the 5 conformity tests, we get all positive observation, and from this we can conclude our sample is glucose. Okay, thank you guys.